Hello guys, and welcome to the next episode of Planet Coaster with me, Biffa. We are now in Alpha 3. I've been so excited for Alpha 3. Look, there's me. Hello! How you doing, Biffa? My teeth do not look like that, but the rest of this fine physique is pretty much an approximation of what I look like. Yay, that's excellent. So we are going to be starting a brand new world, which I'm really looking forward to getting stuck into. Here we go, play. Now, I have been waiting for the challenge mode to be added. In this mode, you need to manage your money to succeed in this work in progress mode. It's a bit too work in progress for me, I'll be honest. I started recording this episode yesterday and tried it in the management mode, I suppose you would call it, where you actually have money and things cost money. And it was very easy to very quickly run out of money and very, very, very hard to make money, which made the progress of recording the video very slow. So rather than do that, because there's so many new things that have been added, I want to do a sandbox mode, and I've got lots and lots of plans. And also now that there's Steam Workshop in, that's going to be absolutely fantastic. Now, Tropical would be nice, but we've done Tropical. I think I'd like to go with Desert, because why not? We can still have all the different modes and different things that we want to do, different areas and all that sort of funky stuff. But it'd just be different. We'd just do something different. We tried Tropical mode last time. Let's get on with the Desert mode. So I'm planning to have... Aha, here we go. Let's look at our area that we've got. Look at this. A lovely large area to be building in, which is very, very funky and cool. I've been downloading lots of things as well, which I'm very excited to try. We'll get to that in a moment. But there's so many new things. Terrain editing has now got water. Oh, dirty water standing rough. Oh, I didn't even realise all of that. We can paint areas and change it. Of course, we've got the sculpting has now officially been added to the game. Loads of different paths. Look at this. We've got natural paths, all sorts of things. Loads of different buildings. We can make this a bit bigger, can't we? There we go. So lots of different buildings to play with. I've actually downloaded a load, like I said. Loads of extra scenery options. And we have pyrotechnics and things as well. Special effects, which was something that was only recently added, so looking forward to trying those out. Got some more things there. Lots of extra rides, which is really good, so I'm looking forward to getting stuck into those. Don't have transport rides yet. Roller coasters has got the biggest change. We've got all these different ones to get stuck into and try, and of course we've got the custom ones as well, which will be great, so looking forward to those. And then there's blueprints that I've downloaded, because let's see the plan I would like to do. I have a list of things, different areas we could have around here, and we can sort of sculpt them individually as we make them. And I've also got something that we could try for the main entrance, which I think will look really, really good. So I would like to do a village out of these areas. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll pick the best ones and we'll start doing those. I think we're going to have a castle area, a Wild West area, and a sort of Disney fairy tale area. I'm just going to mark those on my list as the ones that I've mentioned. Castle, Wild West, and then Disney stroke fairy tale type area. That's the sort of thing that I'm looking to do around here. So that's three areas. And then we can add in things like pirate or Caribbean, a modern area, a little village, something like that. So we will see how we go. But let's have a look. See, all of these things now have money attached to them. I've downloaded these off the Steam Workshop, because with Steam integration, that is going to be fantastic. But, oh, there we go. It's loading in. Look at this for an entrance. Oh, my giddy aunt. So we can place this. We can place this here and have this as our entrance to the park. Let's just pop it down and have a look at the build. This is absolutely fantastic. Now, somebody's made this with all the different parts, and let's have a look. Same as blueprint, edit building. So, oh my goodness, yeah, look, you can see all the different parts, castle window. But I think that makes an absolutely stunning entrance to the park. I believe, I'm trying to think which way to have it, bienvenue, which way to have it facing. I'm probably going to face it the wrong way. Chief Beef, I think you come in here, and that's facing the front, isn't it? So that's fine, we can do that. But I think that just looks absolutely fantastic, doesn't it? So what we're going to do is move this. There we go. Oh, I tell you what I want to do first is, we do that. I want to rotate it. There we go. All new movement keys as well, which are fantastic. We've got angle snap on. So I'm hoping that that is going to line up perfectly with this. I'm not sure how far I can go. I don't think we can go outside. We cannot. Let's get this as close as we can to here. And then check out this entrance. I think this is going to be very, very cool. I think we should go over one little blob. There we go. So we have our entrance to our coaster. And of course, just as we've done that, it's decided to go dark. So what I'm going to do is speed that up so we can get through the night. Oh, and I think this looks absolutely fantastic. Am I able to then easily place paths coming off of there? Let's give that a go. What colour path? I like this stone one. We want to make this nice and wide. I believe that's going to be 10 wide. Nope, it's going to be 8 wide. There we go. Yep, so we can have that coming through here. Very good. Let's just undo that. We'll leave that one there. I think I want to change... I think that path down there is a different colour. And as soon as it gets bright again... Yes, it is. There we go. We can see. So let's change the colour of this. Can I change any more? That's as much as I can change. I can't change anything outside here. That's fine. Look at this. So we're going to walk into here. Then we're going to come through, whiz through there, and enter the park. Fantastic. Let's add a couple of these down. 7:30 in the morning. That's a bit brighter. Things are looking nice. Let me pause the game. Where is the sun? Which way is it coming in? Coming in from over there. Maybe we'll let the day carry on. And then when it gets above us, we'll pause it then. Quick sip of tea. Ah, very good. I think that is a fantastic entrance. Really, really cool. We're going to have to add a lot of lighting and things to this because there isn't any at the moment, but we will get to that. Now, what I would like in here, when you first walk into the park, I would really like the path to sort of go round a couple of... Oh, there's toilets in there, apparently. Oh, I didn't realise. Where were they then? Is that... toilets in there? It is! We have some toilets as when we go in. Oh, let's see if we can put some paths to go to those then. Let's narrow this path up a bit. Let's go a bit narrower. 4. Perfect! Oh, there we go! That is really cool. I'm glad I spotted that because that is perfect. Oops, let's undo that. There we go. That is... Can you let me get back inside, please? We should fly out this way. There we go. Let's get back inside. Yep, that's looking good. I'm liking the way that is looking. There we go. Yep, lined up perfectly. Good. Well, we could maybe do a little something with the entrance here, couldn't we? Just to sort of make this part look a lot nicer. Because it is very dark. Oh, darn it. It's got to night time again and I didn't notice. Okay, I will notice next time. But we could do with adding some lights in here. Oh, people are coming in already. They're coming in to use the toilets. Look, I've hooked them up and they're like, they're going to pay, come in, use the toilets and leave. Isn't that nice? Well, let's look at scenery. Let's look at light. Is that the only light? There's more lights than that, surely. Let's have a look. We have a section for props. And that has lights. There we go. Good. So, let's just get some standard street lamps in here, I think. I don't think... Let's have a look. Oh, there we go. Let's press X again. I think that sort of places it. You can't rotate it before you put it down. You have to place it, then put it down. Exit out of there. Yeah, that'll be good. Let's get back inside again. So, if we can copy that... What's the duplicate key? Trying to remind myself. Control D. There we go. So that's going to face the same way. We're going to put one there. There we go. We've got our lights that light up that area there. Just notice as well outside, we've got some cool special effects things going on, which is really good. Let's pause the game. There we go. So I want to add a bit of scenery, some plants, make this sort of look nice. Maybe have some special effects in here as well. I don't think we've got much room for trees. Let's see if we've got some Corralis-style bushes that we can have. We do, which will be very good. So I tell you what, I'm going to work on this little entrance section here, and then you can tell me what you think once I'm done. We'll be right back. Right, we're heading in with this guy here. Let's speed things up a bit. There we go. And just sort of get a general idea of just a few things that I've added. It does get a little bit dark, doesn't it? But then it's like, ooh, you want to head out into the light. And then as we head out there, which he's not going to see because he's heading to the toilet. So we'll leave that guy to his business. I do not want to follow him in there. But as we head through here, there he goes. We want to see something in the middle here that's going to really draw us through. That's the idea. And that's where, let's come out of here. Oh, I've let the game run on again and it's going to get dark. That's where I want the castle to be. Sort of in there somewhere. But I'm just thinking about doing a little bit here to try and work on some of the terrain stuff. So what have we got here? Push, flatten, smooth, chisel, roughen. Let's try some of the push and see how we go. Intensity's quite high. Let's drop that down. And just sort of, oh, it does nicely smooth it in, doesn't it? I like that. That's quite good. You probably can't see that. Let me just pause until the day starts again. Okay, there we go. You can see what we're doing. So the way this actually works as well, look, it will go straight up to the path. I'm wondering whether to have this to go underneath and have it coming out the other side as well. I think that would be particularly nice, having a nice big pondy sort of area that we walk over. There we go. And then if we can dig that path out underneath, that part out underneath as well, that would be good. Let's make this back up to 8 again. There we go. And then we're going to have some different sections that come off the side here, like that. And I do want one on the other side as well. Push and pull. There we go. Let's flatten this, actually. Flatten to surface. Flatten to foundation. Which is the one that's going to take it across here and do the same? The same as what's already here. I think that's done that. And then we can add our path in. Then we know what we're working to. Ah, that's the way to do it. You need to remove the path. Then you can put the path in. Excellent. And then it'll let you do it. Okay, that's fine. There we go. That's plenty. That's more than enough. Please get off the screen. Okay, so let me dig out a little area here that the paths can go over. I need to try and remember how to do the digging underneath. Oh, it's actually gone through. There we go. It's done it. Fantastic. Has that come out the other side? It has. Just what I wanted. Oh, perfect. That is dead easy to use. And I wonder whether we can zoom out of there. There we go. Zooming sometimes throws you around a bit, but I guess it's just the nature of the beast. There we go. So the path, I'm probably going to manually sort of move it around the side of these. And then what I want around here is some sort of shops. So let's make this a little bit bigger. Okay, just finishing off a little bit of the path around here. Just trying to sort of, I don't want to make the path too clunky. There we go, that's okay. A little bit of a smooth thing around there. I don't want it to be exactly the same on either side. So that's fine how we've got it there. And then this is going to open up and actually be a lot wider as it comes off there. So can I remove that? How big can we go with that? 10. And I want that to snap in the middle there. Maybe 10 is a bit too wide. There we go. No, that's fine. Good. That's it. And then that will start heading off into our main area. So I've not actually played with the water before. So let's take a look at what we can do. We've got calm water, rough water. Okay, let's put in. Is this putting it in? Is that where the level is going to be up to? It is. Oh, there we go. Look at that. Oh, my goodness. So why is that red? It won't let me do it there. That's too high. Okay, that's the place we can go. Is that because it's going to overflow somewhere? I don't know, but that looks pretty good. I like that. Let's change. Can I change that to rough water? Okay, let's do undo, remove that. How high can I put rough water? Can I put calm water? I can put calm water all the way up to the top. Oh, I see. It's different on both sides. Ah, there we go. Oh, that does look fantastic. I like that. Let's try rough water. Put it as high as it will go. Is that going to move? Oh my goodness, it's moving as well. Oh. I have to say... Oh, I see what it is. Okay, let's put calm water back in. Just want it one little drip from the top. And then let's start the game. There we go. Oh, oh, now we're under the water. That's better. That's a nice calm. But look at that reflection. Oh my goodness, that is beautiful. Oh, this is going to add so much to the game. This is just amazing. And and then I just want to fiddle with these paths a bit here just to get this looking a bit nicer. There we go. That's better. Oh, I like that. I really very much like that. And along here, we can certainly have some shops and things where they can spend some money. So I suppose we need to spend a little bit of time making this entrance look nice, because during the day, it's all well lit up. But as it gets to night, this has no lighting on it at all. So I'm just thinking, let's have a look at our scenery and our... No, it's not under scenery, is it? Building? I can't remember where the lights are. Shops and facilities, the lights are here somewhere. I know they are. I'm going to find them. Custom props. Lights. There we go. So I want some coloured spotlights. Some coloured event lights up here. They will be hidden, so we won't see them. What is the key just to rotate before we put it down? Z. Ah, okay. Excellent. Let's try that again then. Whoops, lost it. There we go. Nice. Okay, so if we put some of these along here. Now, what is colour of the event light? We can change the colour now, so that will do all the colours of the rainbow, which is fantastic. I was wondering whether... View mode, small grid, settings... Align to surface, add to building. I don't really want to do that. I was hoping that there's going to be some sort of grid that we could put down on the terrain here to help for lining things up, but I don't think there is. So let's go with our eye and add some of these in along here. So I reckon one in front of each of these. And actually, it doesn't... Every other one of these would be good. Actually, it doesn't matter if they don't line up perfectly. We can sort of follow the contour. There we go. More or less... of the water that we've got there. So that started in the first one and then every other. That one there, that one there. Let's look a bit more natural anyway, won't it? There we go. That will light up that front section. This one here needs to move in a bit, doesn't it? Yeah, there we go. That's more like it. And then, how about some lighting coming down? Is there anywhere we can sort of hide some lighting? We could hide... some lighting around these towers, couldn't we? So maybe I'll give that a go as well. Let's have a look. We've got the little box lights, which they face that way. If we shift Z, nope. I want to face them the other way entirely. Yeah, it's not going to let me do it until I place one, is it? So let's... maybe hang a few from under here. Okay, so I've managed to use the new rotate function to get that to turn the way we want. And also we can do this align to surface, add to building, which I think is an amazing addition. So we can actually have... let's just stick to the front section for now. We can actually have these... let's have a look. Underneath there. I want to duplicate that. Oh my goodness, that's duplicated the whole thing. I just want this. No! What's it doing? It's become part of the building! I just want this! Okay, we'll try that again. Let's move that. Box light. Move. That's going to align to the surface. But as close as we can to there. Oh, it's going to add to building one. I see. I'll tell you what we're going to do. Is we are going to put one of these... we leave it where it was, just do Control D. Ah, there we go. Now if we add them in, it's not going to mess around with everything else. Good, let's do that then. So if you add one there, that That's it, and then we can go back to this, Control D, add one there. Oh, good, okay, that makes sense. That looks nice, that looks nice. So let me add a few more of these. Right, just a little something I'm working on here, which is very interesting. You can actually remove parts of the building. So if I wanted to, let's edit this building here. I can control click and select individual parts like that. You can then, this one here, split selection from building. So I've done that with these ones here. These are now separated. And then if I want to just select these, let's not select anything at the minute. There we go. We've got this multi-selection tool. So it's a bit easier in this case because there's nothing else under here to select. I can select all of these and then save selection, move selection. I can advance move this selection. Let's see, because I want to line it up to go over here. That looks good for there. Then if we move that, the weird thing is it doesn't let me, I think I have to save this as a separate blueprint. Let's have a look what it says. Save selection as blueprint. New blueprint. Oh, okay. This is all new. Thumbnail preview. Item title. Okay. Castle window with lights. Wasn't expecting all this to come up. Castle window with lights. Scenery. Add tags. We'll have window. Oh, okay. It goes under scenery. I see. Create blueprint. Description is required. Castle window with lights. We're learning as we go here. Okay, create blueprints. Okay, so is that now going to be... This still doesn't select as one unit, and I can't control click and select those for some reason. Aha! I've solved it. We go to my blueprints. Now we've saved it as a blueprint. We can select that, and we can now move it around, so we can line that up with the wall. Oh, there we go. It's making me... That's it there. And then if we hold shift, we can go up. I think that's probably... If we place it like that, we can then maybe shift it around a tiny bit. Anyway, there we go. So we can do that. We can add it in. Then we can add the other one on here. Maybe there's a little bit of finickiness that still needs to be ironed out. There we go. We can go that way. We can go that way. Actually, I want to go back first, because I want to make sure I line that up correctly with all of this. There we go. After not too much fiddling around, we managed to get that set in there, which means we probably could do with taking the lights out the top section here, couldn't we? So let's edit and get rid of those. So we've just got this lit at the bottom. Excellent. And it's sort of got to nighttime-ish. We can see how this is looking. That is not too bad. I quite like that. Right, now I'm going to work on what's going to go around this pond area here for our entranceway. Okay, there we go. So I've extended that a little bit more, added some more trees. I think that adds a nice look to it. And I just know what the heck's happened here. Huh? I've pressed undo too many times and I've removed something, haven't I? Whoops, I need to fix that. Okay, well that's fine, I can do that. Let's remove this stone window. I'll get back to fixing that in a moment. And then finally, what I want to do is place the castle that you are going to see at the back here somewhere. Let's just see how big this castle is going to be and which one we are going to pick. And I probably would take your votes on this because I've got a whole load of castles here and I want to see which one... We know which one is going to be a good one. So what have we got here? Right, so these are the castle choices that we have. We have a couple of Disney... I think these are from the different Disney parks. What's it say on the front here? Let's have a look. Ooh, that looks rather nice. I like that. But Disney fairy tale style castles. So I'm not really looking for those at the beginning when you first walk in. This sort of castle is quite good. I like this. This is really well made. So we could take something like that and extend it. See how that goes. This one's quite nice, obviously made to be put on a hill. A bit different, that one. This one's a bit plain and square. This one I really like. It's not a big sort of castle that will wow you as you walk in. It will fit together with that one there. But this has actually got shops built into it, I believe. There we go, look. Some shops over there. So we could run some path to those. I think that would be good. So maybe we'll have something like this. Let's select... Is that going to select the whole building? Let's use our nice new selection tool. There we go. Let's move our selection. Can we do that? We can. And something like that could go in the middle here. Maybe this is what we'll actually start off with. Okay, that looks about right. And then if we just shifty this over slightly, I'm just wondering whether we're going to be able to carry a path on there. Let's say okay to that. Let's see if we can run a path through here. And then this will be... Let's have a look. This one here, I don't think we're going to do a 10. Oh, it's going to let us do a 10. Oh, excellent. That's really good, because then that now looks like it is built on there. Is there no way out of here? There is. So we're going to be forcing... Oh, there's toilets here as well. Oh, fantastic. I may have to fiddle around with the pathing here for a minute and get this lined up. Oh my goodness, I've just spent like 20 minutes trying to get these three paths to connect, and that is like the best that they will do. Wow, and is this going to connect over here as well? It is. It's going to look a bit winky wonky at the side, but... Finally, we've done it. Good grief. That was like a work and a half trying to get that to... The paths are still a little bit interesting. But they're better than they used to be. I'm glad I've managed to get that connected up. I wonder if I could just add... Yeah, I don't really want to do that. I just wanted to stop this bit being weird at the side. But I don't think I can. What's going on over there? Oh, there we go. We've got a guy on duty over here. He's looking great. I'm liking this little area. I really am. This is looking really good. Here they come. The people are streaming in. Oh, my goodness. I was not expecting that. And all there is at the minute is food to buy. Oh, these guys are walking around. No way. Look. There's like a guard on top. Oh, that is fantastic. Oh, I'm absolutely loving the way that this is looking. Well, there we go. I think we're going to bring this first episode looking at Alpha 3 to a close. I'm really loving this game so far. I'm really enjoying the additions that we have here. And the fact we've got Steam Workshop integration means we can have amazing things like this just looking absolutely perfect. So we need to do a lot of work around here. We've got a lot of detail work to work on. Work. And then to start adding rides in, which is what we're going to do next time. So let me know which of the castles you think would be the best one to have up on a hill in a distance to really get people's eye drawn to the back of the park. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7. Or if there's any other castles that you've seen that would be a good addition, let me know and we'll do that. We also need a name for the park. So let me know in the description below what we can call our brand new park. It's got Biffa's Coaster Park, but just between us, we can change that and come up with a cool name. Guys, thank you very much for watching. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you can be sure to not miss out on more Planet Coaster and also other indie games that we're playing at the moment. We have Avon Colony, which is a fantastic bit like Planet Base management sim set in space. That one's working out really good. I'm very much enjoying that. And there's more things to come as well. So I will see you tomorrow for the next episode, or in a couple of days. I think it's every other day it's going to be for Planet Coaster. I will see you then. Take care. Bye-bye.